Welcome everybody, OCD Hi-Fi guy. Now we're in Big John's home right now. There he is. Okay, so now for the guys that don't have a bunch of dough but want some really killer world-class sound, John is a master at finding things on Craigslist, such as these Apogee speakers, which if you haven't heard of Apogee, were legendary. They still are awesome, but back in the day, Apogee, they had a speaker called the Scintilla that was it went down in history as the hardest speaker to drive, period. It was a 1-ohm speaker. They were huge. They would melt amps. A whole class of giant amplifiers was made. You see those big Mark Levinson amps and those big Krells, the huge ones that are like 300 pounds and super big, those were made for Scintilla. Scintilla hatched a whole genre of amplifiers because they were so hard to drive. So anyways, that's a little of the history. But, okay, so these things here, okay, and there he's got a sub right sitting over there. So what did you pick these up for?
$150.
$150, you guys. Did you hear that? And are they
Centaur Miners. So the cheapest ones they made. They got a 6-inch VIFA woofer.
Yep.
And a sealed enclosure.
Yep.
And then they have the 26-inch five-stranded etched.
Ribbon?
It's a ribbon tweeter, but it's made of, what's the material, the yellow material?
Polyamide?
Maybe it's not polyamide. It's, I'll think of the name of it.
Kevlar.
It's etched into the air, like, something like that. Yeah, okay. I can't remember the material.
It's an aramid fiber.
They go down to 800 hertz. Okay. So that's what's magical about them. 800 to
800 hertz ribbon.
Oh,
okay, cool.
So all the way up to 22. You get all the mids in there, and then the woofer in the bottom.
It's almost full range.
And they're dipole, so they sound great, especially if you pull them off the wall, but this ring's too small for it. It's a second rig. So.
Okay, and what do you got powering it?
So I've got the Rode Cronus Magnum 2, so 100 watts.
Okay, and that how much is that thing? That thing was, what do you get? What do those sell for, like, used on the used market? What do they sell for?
$2,000, somewhere around there.
$2,000. I've got one of these, too, by the way, if anybody wants one. It's just sitting there. I got it back from my brother. But because I got it for him as a startup amp.
Single-ended only.
Single-ended, okay.
So it doesn't have a balanced output.
But it's got those are KT120s, right?
KT120s. Okay, so the older ones had 88s, the new ones have 120s.
Okay.
It's super easy to bias, and in 2 years I've only had to bias it one time and just a little bit.
Okay. So we're talking about, with that thing here, that thing's $2,000, let's say, give or take, and then these things were what, $150?
$150.
How much did you have to put any money into them?
Nope. All I did was redo the bases. So these are sand filled bases. They weigh about maybe 10 pounds.
Oh, okay.
And just touch them up.
But yep.
The goal for these, I mean, they're so cheap, is to take the ribbon out and the driver and put them on a piece of proper, like, 18-ply plywood or Baltic birch.
Okay.
So they look good. Because right now, I mean, they're made cheap. So they're rigid and they're. But they acquire that. They get that with just...
Okay. Okay, so you guys, here's a little... That right there, the Apogee, that's a little droplet of hi-fi wisdom, okay, that you wouldn't know if you're just a newbie. But we know because we've been doing this a long time. You can pick these up for $150, and you won't believe
awesome.
The sound. They will smoke anything, I suppose, probably... Well, let's see. I wonder how the LCRs are against these things.
Yeah, so they don't have a lot. They don't go down really low. It's only a 6-inch woofer.
Okay.
But image-wise, like compared to like Maggie's and stuff, they really have this great, great image. And it's sweet, like the smaller Maggie's too.
Yeah.
You got to be seated. You get out of it and you
stand
lose
up.
A sweet
you stand
spot.
Up out of it. Okay.
But I put them down in the big room and drove them with the big edge, and they just the image
they killed
so
it. Yeah.
Well.
Cool. Yeah. Can we listen now? Or is it warmed up?
Yeah.
Okay, so we've been warming up the Cronus Magnum. That's a Rogue amp. That thing is made in the United States. It's a great company. They make them. They're reasonably priced, and it's made in America. And they're great little amps. And I have one. If anybody wants to buy one, I'll sell it for $2,000. And it has the home theater bypass option. And it has whatever option. It was loaded. And it's got zero, it's probably not even broken in yet. I got it for my brother with some small Maggies so he could start his hi-fi career, but he just totally flailed. He's a studio guy, man. He's a studio guy. So somehow he doesn't have an audio system. I don't know if there's any studio guys that have audio rigs at home. It's kind of like you don't want what you work with every day, like in your face when you go back home. So,
Get the sub out of here.
Tear holes in the fabric.
And as you guys know, with the tube amps like that, you can tube roll. You get some. Secrets we have, all that we have is alive. Hold the line till this thread comes undone. If you're thinking of letting me go, then it's time that you do. Oh, yeah, that's. I was like, God, they make a. I forgot about the sub. Cold, it's not fully warmed up yet, but still sounds pretty killer.
And there's no DAC here either, it's just streaming Bluetooth off title.
You're kidding.
Bluetooth off title.
How's it getting Bluetooth over there? You got a receiver?
Yeah, a little Bluetooth receiver. So this
okay.
is totally the source is just it's a good source, but Bluetooth is
okay. So
limited.
Okay, so check that out. This is as shitty as it's gonna sound. Mm-hmm. That's what he just said.
This is just. I got them out of the basement.
Yeah. So this, I mean, you get a good DAC, a good,
This straight up HiFi, the monitors are great.
Yeah.
Apogee built a great speaker. Red Riders of the
Dark, help me through. Yeah, it's like a full-on, you know, wall of sound. Do you know this? There's nothing empty, you know, in between these. It's all just full of sound and music. The stage. Okay, yeah. Another thing is you get like, see how that's stuffed in the corner? These things, you get them out from the corner, and they're even better. You got any Kenny G, dude? No, I was kidding. I just asked for Kenny G. That was a joke. I used to work in a record store in Los Angeles on Venice Beach, and we used to put on stuff like that. Like, we had the music that we would choose for getting everybody out of the store at night, right? Close at 9 o'clock or whatever. So we would pick just the most obnoxious music that we could. I remember some of them was Partridge Family was one of them. Diamante Galas, which is just like performance art, gnarly just stuff. I think, what's that other guy's name? That punk rocker? I can't remember his name. You guys probably remember. He takes crap on stage and stuff. What's his name? I can't remember his name. Anyways, he's nasty. So that, you know, it's kind of fun. We'd have another thing we used to do at the record store. People would come in and say, do you have that one song? And then they'd sing it. And we'd bring the other guys over. We'd be like, hold that 1 second, let me see. We'd bring over the other guys. Okay, so do it again. We'd have them do it like 3 or 4 times. And then we'd go, no, we don't know the song. And we knew it. You know, hey, it's the kind of things you do when you're a kid living in Venice, 20 years old. It's entertainment, you know? Okay, so this is killer. Hell of a value. $150, man. You can be in hi-fi. See, everybody says, I don't have enough money to be in hi-fi, but that's bullshit. Because this is legit hi-fi for $150. You just need to know what you're looking for. These are called Apogees. A-P-O-G-E-E. You know, go find them. Make sure they're in decent shape. And man, because no one knows what they are, they give them away. And you set these upright, like we pulled these away from the wall and got them in a little, we could dial them into like three-dimensional soundstage, you know, without too much problem. And then you're hearing right now, again, Bluetooth off a phone, man, over to a little teeny receiver and DAC that's like size of a, you know, it's as crappy as it's as of a source as you could have. So that's pretty cool. All right, you guys, we'll see you later. See you.